As a doctor, what are you loving to do? What would you love to do?
Teach children.
Children. So you are going to become children specialist.
Praise God.
Because what you love, please don't go for any other thing. Ask yourself, what do I love the most? And am I willing to work for no salary? And still I would love to do. Then you will be enjoying the work. Now I'm doing the work. Am I on salary?
No.
Hello, am I on salary?
No.
But how many hours I'm working?
More than 18 hours.
What is the reason why I'm working?
Because you love it.
You love it.
So what I love. Now, if you take me and put me for babysitting, okay, you will find me a big failure. Don't tell anybody. I'll tell you something that happened. Can I tell you?
Yes. Says,
this will help you. Can I tell you?
Yes, brother.
I was in New Zealand. And this mama told me, I'm going to drop my child to school. So my younger son, I leave him with you. You can play with him. The younger son is very good to me. Small boy, might be 3 years old. Okay. So the mama went to drop the baba. And God only knows what happened to me. I fell off to sleep. After 25 minutes, the mama came. She opened the door. She had the key. She opened the door. And she said, where's my son? I jumped out of my sofa in a jerk. And first thing I ran was the toilet. I searched the washing machine. I searched the toilet. I searched under the bed. We searched for 10 minutes and no sign of him. I asked this mother, does he know to open the door? She said, no. So that means he's somewhere in the house, but not to be seen. Can you believe my first episode of babysitting in my life? Now I was literally praying to God and saying, God, show me where he is. He's inside the house. Where? Now that boy had cuddled himself so small that he put a towel on him and then he put two pillows on him. So he was just opposite sofa, so small, with two pillows on it, so you can't see him. But from that day on, I made a decision. I will never ever do babysitting for anybody. Do I love that job? So now I'm going to US to learn babysitting because I'm becoming a grandpa.
Praise God.
So I'm going to learn now this time.
Praise God.
Because my two babies, I was a very nasty fellow. So I don't even know when they grew up. So now I'm going to become once again learning what I should have learned as a dad. So Giselle,
God,
sit with the Lord and tell him, Lord, tell me and show me what do I love the most. And don't look for money. Don't look for fame. Don't look for anything. Just that. And then you will discover your assignment. Because what you love the most is the clue to your assignment. So when you have love for something, that love will birth in you wisdom. And that wisdom, with understanding how to apply it in your day-to-day life, will now bring the solution and solve the problem in that area that you love. Now, when I look back, I can say without a doubt that even though I had no knowledge about the Bible or about the church, I was the person sitting outside the church, but yet there was something that happened. The love for the word not only changed my life, I discovered that this is an assignment that God has given me, that I need to go and share the same wisdom with others and teach them that they also can get results. Praise God.
Praise God. Praise God.
So what is it that is within inside of you that God has already given you? And it is unique, it is special, it is not a duplicate. And your job is now to discover this great gift that is within you. And the key to discover is love. You need to go into the Bible and see the lives of those whose names are written in the Bible, their character, and how did they face trials, and how did they discover God's calling, and now begin to imitate them, begin to relate yourself to them. And this is one of the most important things that each one of us can do. You must find what you really care about and develop your life around it. Praise God.
Praise God.
Is it making sense to all the mamas?
Yes.
Yes. Brother, I have a question. But since we have free will.
Sorry?
Since we have free will, can't we learn to love something?
You can learn to love something. Now, for example, I love to be in the choir. And I even practice singing. One night with the headphones on. And my wife had to come from a sleep, deep sleep, and say, at 1 o'clock in the morning, why are you screaming? Everybody must be getting disturbed. Now I know that that's not my calling. But because I love music, because I love singing, do you know what God made me? A DJ. Have you ever heard me become a DJ in any of the retreats? Have you seen? I play only one song. And that one song might go for 40 minutes. And in one song, there will be healing, there will be deliverance, there will be prayer, there will be anointing, everything inside that one song.
Praise God.
In that one song, in that one chorus, it will be not the chorus, but only one line is repeated again and again. So I don't sing hymns like everybody else sings. I sing hymns to build up faith, to build up my spirit. So I will not take the whole song. I will take only two lines and play it. Praise God.
Praise God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank
it's been
you,
a
Jesus.
Long time that I've not gone into that. But otherwise I would have shown you. After the session, I'll show you. Okay? So with that, I don't need the choir members. I don't need anybody. I can open my laptop and make anybody sing the way I want. The way I love to do the praise and worship.
Praise God.
You have never seen any of my videos?
Yes, sir. You tell the choir to sing one particular line again and again and again.
Yes.
But the effect of it is amazing.
Yes.
It's good.
So, what I loved, I would not get people to sing that way. So God gave me and showed me a software where my desires are fulfilled. So it's not wrong to love something, but even though you love something, it will be far inferior compared to what God has already pre-planned for you, which is going to be extremely on the top level compared to what you are trying to do. That is why it is more and more important that I discover my calling. I discover what is it that I love to do. And what I love to do, I got to go after it with all my heart. So it is extremely wise to acknowledge and embrace your gifts, your expertise, your experience that God has given you to build you up so that you can share the same with others. So you are what you are created for. So when you go out and do anything other than that, it will be just like you when you are chasing the truth on Google. It looked like you are on the right track, and it looked like you were spending so much time, and it was such a great discovery. But as you went deeper and deeper, you found yourself that I'm getting lost of my own identity. So whenever I want to do what I want, it's going to be far, far inferior compared to what God wants me to do.